few years back, news headlines mentioned names like BT Cotton, BT Brinjal, and so on. And even the markets were flooded with them. Any idea what these are? That's right. They are genetically modified crops, abbreviated as GM plants. We have heard about them several times. These plants are the modified versions of the original variety. Modifications in the plants adds many advantages like greater yield, insect resistance, nutritional value, and so on. But how do we modify the plants? How is the transformation carried out? For that, each plant part acts as a mini laboratory. Several experiments are carried out on each part. At the end of many such experiments, finally a product is achieved that has the desired characters. So in order to make useful products, we modify the crops. But in order to modify them, we need to study each and every part of the plant in detail. In this and in the upcoming sessions, let's learn and understand each part of the plants in detail. And where do we begin with? The top or the bottom? Let's toss and choose which part to begin with. If it's heads, we begin with the shoot. And if it's tails, we begin with the roots. So let's get started. Here we go. We've got tails. So now let's begin with studying a typical plant beginning with the roots and moving to the shoots. Let's start our understanding of the roots first. There are three major areas of study that we need to carry out. First is the type of roots. Second is the various regions or the parts of the roots. And lastly, we'll study the various modifications of the roots. Let's begin with the types of the roots first. Here we see a carrot and an onion in the soil. If we uproot both plants, where can you locate the roots in both of these? Well, this complete structure of a carrot is like a root. Yes, in case of a carrot, this complete structure is the main root, which is edible. On the other hand, in case of this onion, we find these small bunch-like structures. These are its roots. So can we say that there are two major types of roots? Well, there are various types of roots found throughout the plant kingdom. But we will restrict ourselves to three major types. The first one is the category of carrots. These type of roots are called taproots. The second type is the one in which there are bunch-like structures, the ones found in this onion. These are called the fibrous roots. And the last type, which we're yet to discuss, is called as adventitious roots. This type involves the roots which arise from other parts of the plant body and not the main roots below the stem. Don't get confused. Let's understand each type better. Taproot system is the one in which there is a single root, which is the primary root that anchors the plant. The one seen in this case. There are several secondary and tertiary roots, that is these smaller roots like structure, which arise from the primary root. The primary root has the tendency to grow deeper in the soil. Usually, dicot plants exhibit the taproot system. The second type is that of a fibrous root system. This type does not contain a single primary root. Rather, many smaller roots come together to form a bunch-like structure. These roots usually do not grow too deep unless the tree is very huge. And what kind of plants exhibit this type of system? That's right. Monocots usually have the fibrous root system. Now comes the last type from our list. That is the adventitious root system. This type deals with the roots that unusually originate from the other parts of the plants, like the branches, stem, leaves, or even some old woody roots at times. Have you ever seen a huge banyan tree? Any idea what these string-like structures are? Well, these are actually the roots. Yes, a banyan tree like this one has these string-like structures. These are the prop roots which arise from the branches. These roots are called aerial roots, which are a type of adventitious roots. As we can see here, the roots arise from the aerial plants, the branches. They grow from above the ground, and they firmly adhere to the ground, giving the huge tree a proper structural support as well. Note that the banyan tree does have a proper root system under the ground. The adventitious roots are just additional ones that help in making a few systems work efficiently in the plant body. This is one example of adventitious roots. Now, before moving ahead with the next section, let's revise the types of the roots once. The first type is that of the taproots. This type has a single, long primary root system and smaller secondary and tertiary roots arising from it, just like in the case of carrots. The second type is the fibrous roots. In this type, several smaller roots come together to form a single bunch-like structure, just like in the case of onion's roots. Lastly, we have the adventitious root system. Here, the root arises from the different parts of the plant like the stem, branches, leaves, and so on. The prop roots of the banyan tree can be considered as a good example of the adventitious roots. So this was about the types of roots. We shall have a look at the next topic, that is the regions or the parts of the roots, in the upcoming video. Do subscribe to our channel to get updated about the launch of our next video.